The youngest Apollo 8 crew member, Lunar Module Pilot William Anders, 35, was a space rookie until this flight. He's a major in the Air Force and also a graduate of Annapolis. In addition, he has a master's degree in nuclear engineering.
We have commit. We have liftoff. Liftoff at 7:51.
We went into the shadow of the moon, where we were both in the shadow of the moon from the sun and the shadow of the moon from Earthshine, and it was dark. There were stars everywhere. You couldn't tell which ones they were. There were so many. And I remember looking back and seeing all these stars, and suddenly there was this big black hole. And I got to tell you, the hair went up on the back of my neck, because that was the moon. We were busy shooting pictures of the lunar surface for a geologic analysis, but mainly for taking pictures of lunar landing sites for upcoming lunar landings. And then suddenly I looked out the window and here was this gorgeous orb coming up.
Oh my God, look at that picture over there. There's the Earth coming up. Wow, is that pretty. Got a color film, Jim?
Yeah, I'm looking for one. C-368.
Anything, quick.
Here. Oh, that's a beautiful shot.
For me, it made me realize that the Earth was small, delicate, and not the center of the universe. Well, I made the comment somewhere along the line that we went to the moon to explore the moon. What we really did was just discover the Earth. And it didn't really sink in on me for a while, but others picked it up. It sort of gave a kickstart to the environmental movement. And so I think Earthrise will go down in history as an iconic first real view of our home planet, which is very fragile and very delicate.
I think I must have the feeling that the travelers in the old sailing ships used to have. Going on a very long voyage away from home, and now we're headed back. And I have that feeling of being proud of the trip, but still happy to be going back home and back to our home port.